Today, we're talking about metabolism and how it's a key part of health and self-care. My metabolism doesn't work. It's broken. Why does my body betray me? Sound familiar? I know, it's overwhelming. But here's the good news. Our bodies are smarter than we think. Contrary to popular beliefs, studies show that our metabolism is actually hard to break, unless there is an underlying health condition. Maybe the better question we can ask, am I taking care of my body enough? Am I nourishing my body enough to help my metabolism function at its best? And in this video, we're gonna explore this question. Hello guys, welcome back to the channel. It's Mervi Selin here. I used to be a lawyer turned dietitian to follow my dreams. And now as a dietitian, I'm specializing in sport nutrition and gut health. Welcome. In this video, I'm gonna walk you through what metabolism really is and how we can boost it by nourishing mind, body, and soul with science-based strategies, of course. Metabolism, all the reactions that occur in the body to keep us going. Every process in the body needs energy. And when we say metabolism, we refer to total daily energy expenditure, how many calories we burn per day. Studies show that two women with the same age, height, and weight can have vastly different caloric needs. One may burn only 1500 calories, while the other may burn as much as 5500 calories per day. How brutal is that, right? Don't you want to eat more without gaining weight? Even though genetic factors play a decent role in this, there are some strategies we can implement to increase our daily energy expenditure. Now let's take a look at which factors affect this total energy and how we can manipulate them. The total daily energy expenditure is mainly made up of four components. Basal metabolic rate, which is the minimum energy that our body needs to keep us alive. Even if we lay in bed all day long, our body needs to sustain breathing, blood circulation, digestion, maintaining body temperature, etc. And it expenses approximately 70% of daily energy. The second component is NEAT, non-exercise activity thermogenesis. This part is our everyday movements, walking, fidgeting, cleaning, shaking hands. Our third component is physical activity, aka exercise, like strength training, cardio, yoga, dancing. Here the difference from NEAT is intentional movement, exercise purpose. NEAT and exercise comprise approximately 20% of daily energy, depending on how active the person is. And finally, we have thermic effect of food. This is the amount of energy our body uses to digest, absorb, and process the food we eat. It typically accounts for about 10% of our total daily energy expenditure. Protein is the most energy-costly nutrient, requiring about 30% of its calories to be used for digestion. And it's estimated that fiber follows closely, even whether it sweeps off the other components together with itself from intestine. Thermic effect of food is around 5 to 10% for carbs and between 0 to 5% for fats. Now let's talk about how we can play out with these components to boost our metabolism. First thing first, let's shed light on the aging misassumption. According to these studies, in contrast to popular idea, our fat-free mass-adjusted daily expenditure stays fairly stable from the age of 20 to 60. Then after 60, it starts declining. The main reason why we observe these changes in pregnancy, menopause, or 40s, 50s is most likely related to hormones, body composition, and lifestyle changes. We change jobs, environment, have kids, change countries, experience grief, etc. Thereby, our metabolism is not broken, at least until 60. It needs self-care, nourishment, and proper fueling. Although it looks like NEAT and exercise are one of the most flexible parts of our metabolism that we have control over, they only take up 20 to 30% of our daily energy expenditure. To see a real increase in metabolism, we need to work with this 70%. Which brings us to the discussion around BMR, basal metabolic rate. Now listen closely because things are getting interesting here. Metabolic rate is highly individual, like a fingertip. It depends several factors like genetics, gender, height, body composition, and even our gut microbiota. Body composition refers to fat and muscle ratio in the body. We want to decrease fat mass while increasing the muscle mass. Muscle is a metabolically active organ. That means it burns more calories even when we are at rest. The more muscle we have, the higher basal metabolic rate. Let's take two identical twins with same gender, age, height, weight. One has more muscle, the other one has more body fat. Even though they see the same number on the scale, the twin with more muscle will burn more energy throughout the day, even while resting. That's why body composition matters so much more than just numbers on a scale. If we focus on building and preserving muscles, we actually support more efficient metabolism. And this is exactly what we want for our bodies, not just aesthetic purposes, but more for having a healthy and strong body, eating more without gaining weight, getting more nutrients into the body to nourish ourselves at best, feeling more happy and satisfied, having a good relationship with food, and finally, having a healthy gut microbiota. By the way, it is worth noting that men generally have higher muscle to fat ratio than women, which is one reason they tend to have slightly faster metabolism than women. As women, we need more fat between 16 to 25%. For men, the ratio can reduce to 6 to 25%. To maintain a healthy body composition, we need increased muscle mass. And we can achieve this with strength training and adequate protein intake. Okay, let's recap all metabolism boosting strategies. First, maintaining a healthy body composition, which means that adequate amount of protein and strength training. Second, adequate fiber intake like veggies, fruits, legumes, grains. Remember thermic effect of food. Third, active lifestyle. Fourth, avoiding low-calorie diets because they can throw off metabolic balance by causing starvation mode. And last but not least, taking care of gut health. Thank you so much for listening to me. I hope you found this video helpful. If you did, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel for more science-based nutrition. As always, I hope you give the nourishment you deserve to your mind, body, and soul. See you.